This video will focus on tidal heating, also called tidal flexing, which involves objects that are heated by being repeatedly worked, stretched, and released. The core mechanism underlying tidal heating is differential gravity. When a moon is pulled on by a planet's gravity, gravity pulls on the near side more strongly than the far side, effectively stretching the planet. This differential gravity depends upon the mass m of the planet, the mass m of the moon, the radius r of the moon, and inversely as the cube of the moon-planet separation r. Note that the separation cubed factor dominates. Tidal forces are only large for objects nearby each other. Here we depict a moon in a circular orbit about a planet. Although differential gravity is present, it is always the same, as all of the four quantities involved are the same. The planet's gravitational pull on the near side is always a little stronger than that on the far side, at every point in the orbit. However, for a moon in an elliptical orbit, the differential gravity varies. It is much larger when the moon is close to the planet than when the moon is far away. This variation in differential gravity stretches the moon as it orbits. Let's explore some related physics. Imagine that we have a heavy steel ball and we drop it onto a tabletop. The ball has energy of motion, what physicists call kinetic energy, immediately before it hits. What happens to this kinetic energy when the ball hits the table? Classroom students should follow normal procedures or instructor guidelines. Viewers not in a classroom should record your vote and explain your reasoning on a piece of paper. Please pause this video and answer the question. Note that when we view the situation in an infrared camera, we can see the bright area at the impact site of the table indicative of higher temperature. So, converted into thermal energy is the best answer, although converted into sound energy is also correct, as we hear the impact. The first answer is especially wrong. Energy is a conserved quantity. It changes form, but it cannot disappear. All of the kinetic energy of the moving ball must still be present in some form. Another form of this demonstration has two steel balls that are smacked together. If one places a piece of paper at the impact site, it is easy to burn a hole in the paper. We can achieve something similar by rubbing hands and viewing them in the IR camera. This demonstration allows us to repeatedly flex the strip of metal. Let's view this flexing in the infrared camera. Note that the strip slowly starts to glow as its temperature is raised. We will speed up the frame rate for this demonstration. The energy of motion input by the demonstrator is being converted into thermal energy. In all three cases, the impact of the steel ball, the rubbing of hands, and the flexing of the strip of metal, kinetic energy is being converted into thermal energy. The flexing of the strip is most like what happens to a moon in an elliptical orbit around a planet. Jupiter is an extremely massive planet, and Io orbits in a small elliptical orbit, giving rise to the most active volcanism in the solar system. Let's look at a simulation useful for exploring Io's tidal forces. We can see Io in an exaggerated elliptical orbit around Jupiter. The gravitational pull of Jupiter, greater on the near side of Io and lesser on the far side, is shown for four locations in the orbit. Note that the differential pull, the difference in the pull of gravity, is greater when Io is close to Jupiter. So why does Io stay in an elliptical orbit? Astronomers would expect that its orbit would become circular over time. It has to do with orbital resonances with the other moons. Here, the four large Galilean satellites are shown. Io in red, Europa in blue, Ganymede in green, and Callisto is shown in orange, but really doesn't have much impact here. Note that the orbital periods are such that in the time that Ganymede makes an orbit, Europa makes two orbits, and Io makes four orbits, a 1:2:4 resonance. Thus, both Europa and Ganymede regularly gravitationally pull Io in the same direction, shown here by arrows, elongating the orbit. More teaching materials can be found on the web at astro.unl.edu.